Hello children, welcome again in this online class which conducted by RO Jabalpur and I Madhulata Yadav of KV number 1 Sagar going to teach you about microorganism friend and foe chapter 2 of class 8. Before starting my class I would like to share some thought with you that if you have interest of learning, then number of modes of learning present nowadays. And online teaching is one of them. Have you ever thought that you are the people of that world where online teaching you people have started in just age of 12 and 13 years? So, after 25 or 30 years, how would be your world? Just think about it. Let's come to our topic. The topic is microorganism, friend and foe. We have studied in our previous video about the microorganisms, microscope, where do microorganisms live? Different type of microorganisms, classification of microorganisms, bacteria, algae, protozoa, fungi and viruses. Now in this video, we will discuss about microorganism and us, friendly microorganisms, making of curd and bread, commercial use of microorganisms, medicinal use of microorganisms, vaccine, increasing soil fertility, cleaning the environment. Let us study one by one. Microorganism and us. As we know, microorganisms play an important role in our lives. Some of them are beneficial in many ways, whereas some other are harmful and cause diseases. So we can divide all these microorganisms on the basis of their functioning into two groups, that is friendly microorganisms and second one is harmful microorganisms. First, we will discuss about the friendly microorganisms. Microorganisms are used for various purposes. They are used in the preparation of curd, bread and cake. They are also used for the production of alcohol. They are also used in cleaning up of the environment, for example, the organic waste, that is vegetable peels, remains of animals, faces, etc. are broken down into harmless and usable substances by bacteria, and that usable substances are used by the other organisms. Microorganism also used for the medicinal purpose, for making the antibiotics, and also used to increase soil fertility. So here first we will discuss about the making of curd and bread. You know that your mother when set a curd, so what she did? She added a little curd into warm milk to set curd for the next day. So why she did this? Because milk is turned into curd by bacteria. And curd contains several microorganisms. Of these, the bacterium lactobacillus promote the formation of curd. It means the lactobacillus bacteria play an important role in conversion of milk into curd. That bacteria multiplies in milk and convert it into curd. Bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickle, and many other food items. Here you can see the idli, pickles. So you know very well how idli prepared in your house, and for this your mother soaks some rice and pulses one day before, and after that, after she grind that soaked rice and pulses and prepare a batter and keep that batter for 6 to 8 hours. So there is some bubbles you can see in that batter, and a little smell is also present in that batter, and the batter is prepared ready for making idli or the dosa. So actually, what happened in this batter? To understand this, why the batter is giving the smell or the some bubbles like structure you can see in that batter, to understand that you have to do this activity. And for this, you take 1/2 kg flour or the atta or the maida and add some sugar and mix with warm water, and add a small amount of yeast powder which you get from the market. Yeast you can get easily from the market, and need to make a soft dough like this. You have to make a soft dough and keep this dough for 2 hours. Keep it as it is for 2 hours. So what do you observe after 2 hours? Did you find any changes in the dough? Yes, you will find this type of change in the dough. Now dough is rising. So how this has happened? Actually, the yeast you mixed in the dough, that reproduce rapidly and produce carbon dioxide during respiration. Bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increase its volume. Here. And this is the basis of the use of yeast in the baking industries for making bread, cakes, and pastries. Here. And this phenomena is used by the bakery. Now, we will discuss about the commercial use of microorganism, because in the large scale, microorganism will also involve in production of alcohol, like the formation of the alcohol, wine, and acetic acid. So here microorganisms are used for the large scale. Here yeast is used for commercial production of alcohol and wine, and for this purpose yeast is grown on natural sugar present in grains like barley, wheat, rice, crushed fruit juice, etc. So now here you can see all these type of material, alcoholic material, are produced by the microorganisms. And for production of this, a large factories are set up by the different companies or the government also. What actually happened in this alcoholic formation? So by this activity, you will easily understand how alcohol produced by the microorganisms. For this, you have to take a 500 ml beaker and filled up to 3/4 with water and dissolve 2-3 teaspoons of sugar in it and stir it. After that, add 1/2 spoon of yeast powder to the sugar solution. Keep it covered in a warm place for 4-5 hours. After 4-5 hours, you just smell the solution. Can you get a smell? Yes. You will get very pungent smell. So from there, where this smell come? This is the smell of alcohol where sugar has been converted into alcohol by yeast. And this process of conversion of sugar in alcohol is known as fermentation. And here is the Louis Pasteur. He first discovered the method of fermentation in 1857. And 1857 is a historical date for the India. So you will easily learn in 1857 Louis Pasteur discovered method of fermentation. Now next, medicinal use of microorganism. When you go, whenever you fall ill, the doctor may give you some antibiotics, tablets, capsules or injections, such as penicillin or the tetramycin, etc. So the source of these medicines is microorganisms. As some bacteria and fungi are used to make medicines which kill or stops the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. And such medicines are called antibiotics. Example, streptomycin, tetramycin, erythromycin, etc. The antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific microorganisms and are used to cure a variety of diseases. Antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock and poultry to check microbial infection in animals. So to protect the animals, there is also antibiotics used. They are also used to control many plant diseases. So you can say some of the farmer also used antibiotics for the plants. Now how this antibiotic discovered? So first, the discovery of the penicillin in 1929 is the Alexander Fleming. And the Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. He was doing the study that time and he was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. So suddenly he found that the spores of a little green mold in one of his culture plates. So he observed that the presence of mold prevented the growth of bacteria on which he is working. So that mold prevented the growth of bacteria. In fact, it also killed many of these bacteria. Now he got the result that some of the mold can stop the growth of the bacteria. So from this, the mold penicillin was prepared. and this is the first antibiotics which was prepared by the Alexander Fleming. One more interesting thing is that, did you know, it is important to remember that antibiotics should be taken only on the advice of a qualified doctor. We can't take it in our own decision. If we are not feeling well, so we are not taking antibiotics without advice of qualified doctor. Because if you will take antibiotics without prescriptions or prescribed by the doctor, or if you take antibiotics when not needed or in wrong doses, it may make the drug less effective when you might need it in future. Because antibiotics taken unnecessary may kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. As we know, there are some bacteria which are beneficial and always present in our body. They are also helpful for us. Next is, that is vaccine. So what do you understand by the vaccine? I think in your childhood, you must have been given injections to protect yourself against several diseases. So what was that? Why you vaccinated? So to understand this, when disease-carrying microbes enters our body, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. The body also remembers how to fight the microbes if it enters again. If dead or weakened microbes are introduced into a healthy body, the body fights and kills the invading bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. So the antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease-causing microbes forever. So several diseases, including cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, and hepatitis, can be prevented by vaccination. Here, did you know that Edward Jenner, he first discovered the vaccine for smallpox in 1798. The smallpox was also a very dangerous disease. Now the vaccines are given by the doctors. Here are pulse polio program. There are the vaccines can be the injected in the body or given by the orally. You can say the some of the vaccines can be given by the oral method, that is pulse polio. You might have seen the advertisement on TV and newspapers regarding protection of children against polio under the pulse polio program. And the polio drops given to children are actually a vaccine. And one more thing, here is the smallpox. This was also a worldwide campaign against smallpox. Has finally led to its eradication from most of the world. Now here are the vaccine related to the smallpox. Okay, now this smallpox disease is eradicated by the vaccination. Now, increasing soil fertility. as we are now discussing about the friendly microorganism. So this is one of the work by the friendly microorganism, that some bacteria are able to fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to enrich soil with nitrogen and increase its fertility. And these microbes are commonly called biological nitrogen fixers. As you know, there are abundant nitrogen present in the atmosphere, but plants are not capable to take that free nitrogen directly. So these microorganisms which are present in the nodules of the plants, they convert that free nitrogen into the nitrogenous compound. And this nitrogen compound are found in the soil, and plants get in the dissolved form through the water. They take that nitrogenous compound and prepare the different components of the food or the food material which is required for the growth of the plant. So in this way, microorganisms help in increasing soil fertility. Another one is that cleaning the environment. It means microorganisms also play a role of cleaner for the environment. So microorganisms decompose dead organic waste of plants and animals and convert them into simple substances. You heard the word manure. Manure is also prepared by the microorganisms. So microorganisms decompose that all dead organic waste of the plant, even animals also, and convert them into the simple substances which are again used by other plants and animals. Thus microorganisms can be used to degrade the harmful and smelly substances and thereby clean up the environment. So now here you can see variety of works which is done by the microorganism, and in this way they are helping us in a different manner. So in this video we have studied about the friendly microorganism. In our next video we will discuss about the harmful microorganisms and nitrogen cycle, where microorganisms also involve in nitrogen cycle. So thank you children, stay home, stay safe, and do study with a smile. Thank you.